Alejandro Vega on percussion will be needed tonight with the salsa. Welcome back to Dancing with the Stars from wherever you're watching around Australia, or on your couch at home, or even in a hospital bed. And on that note, can I just quickly say a cheerio to my dear friend June Brackey, who is not well. She's watching from her hospital bed. She was worked in television. She's spent most of her life working in live television with IMT, with Graham Kennedy, Bert Newton. She's worked on Hey Hey for many years. She's not well, but she's looking at this program tonight. And June, I hope it meets with your approval, because you're a stickler for things happening and being on time, because she was a director's assistant for many a year. We now go to Chris Hemsworth. He's up now. He's gone from, like, in the first show, he was last place. And then last week, our fifth show, he was third place. So he's turned the corner, and he's, you know, suddenly sort of found his feet, which will come in handy for his foxtrot.
Wilson. Seven.
Hey, 28.
It was great to finish top three and not on the bottom.
What happened to the other Chris?
So now I'm a little bit worried if the old one comes back, but hopefully I can keep him hidden.
I don't know what's going on with Chris Hemsworth this week, but he's on fire. He's picked this dance up so quickly. And I think maybe he's in the dancing zone now.
Just like, I was born with that.
Well, me and Abby, we have a few creative discussions at times.
Did
we not do one on the right foot?
No.
I'm not the only one that makes mistakes. Counting is a bit of an issue for her.
First, two, seven, eight. Step,
what did I do wrong?
Swivel step, I can't count. Five, three. Four.
Okay. Five, three, four.
Chris has a pretty unique way of warming up.
I go into kind of a trance-like state.
And sometimes he just needs to get all his silliness out of his system.
Something inside me just takes over, and I lose it across the floor, and some magic happens, some hideous things happen. Whatever works up.
Dancing the Foxtrot, please welcome Chris Hemsworth and his partner Abby Ross to the floor.
Stars shining bright above you, night breezes seem to whisper, I love you. Birds singing in a sycamore tree, dream a little dream of me. Stars fading, but I linger on deep, still craving your kiss. I'm longing to linger till dawn deep, just saying this. Sweet dreams till sunbeams find, sweet dreams that leave all worries behind you. But in your dreams, whatever they be, dream a little dream of me. Dream of, dream a little dream of, dream a little dream of me.
Abby? I was detecting, I was watching those spins at the end, and I thought, oh, yes, a little Fred Astaire, and then suddenly there was a Gene Kelly leap right at the very end there, near the stairs. I'll let you get your breath back, and we'll go to Helen first up.
Lovely choice of music tonight, and Chris, you have made big steps forward in the Latin, and you really are quite flexible in that, and that's an asset. But in the ballroom, you're probably a little bit too flexible in that way, although you did improve your hold tonight from the... I remember the very first week when I think you did waltz, you had the straightest left arm I've ever seen in my life. At least that's bending now. No, that's better. That is improvement. And in some ways, you moved across the floor reasonably well. But you really do need to work on your posture in this dance. You've got sort of your shoulders going in one direction, sometimes your hips going in another. So if you could improve that, you're halfway there.
Todd?
Yeah, I'm going to be quite tricky. I thought the foxtrot is one of the hardest ballroom dances to do, if not the hardest. And with your height difference, it's going to be hard to swing your leg through, and you've got to keep that body contact without sticking your bum out. And I was really expecting you to sort of come out with all those problems. But you did keep it together. You did keep your hips underneath you. And what I loved about halfway through, you started singing the music there, which means that your head's not concentrating completely on the technique of the dance. And that's what you needed to do at the beginning. You needed to throw it all away and lighten up. And you have done that. You're never going to be Fred Astaire, but I think you're going down his road, but you're a few blocks back.
Another country.
Yeah. But do you know what? I commend you on the distance that you've travelled in this competition.
Yeah. Right. Oh, great. Thanks.
Yeah. Well, there we go.
Cool.
And we're getting the scores after the break, so we can just stand here and the scores after the break, unless you would like to say something before we go to the break.
No, let's go to the break.
Abby, you want to say anything before we go to the break?
I don't think so.
So what about our judges? They never get to check. Let's go to the break! Go to the break! Quick! Quick!